Hello friends, I hope you are doing good. Bridging open work permit. If you are residing in Canada and if you have already applied for your permanent residency application and waiting for the decision from the IRCC, then you must be familiar with this term. Let me tell you, this is not the regular step-by-step process video where I'm going to teach you how to apply for a bridging open work permit. Instead, I'm going to touch down some of the specific points where most of the people get confused or they might have a question while they are applying for the bridging open work permit. So bottom line is, if you are planning to apply for BOWP in future, I suggest you to spend a few minutes behind this video. It will be worth it. That's my promise. So without further ado, let's get started. Hello friends, my name is Akasa and welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to discuss about bridging open work permit application. So let's start with the definition. If you are living in Canada and working as a worker, you have already applied for a permanent residency under Express Entry or PNP stream and you are waiting for the decision from the IRCC. Let's assume your work permit is about to expire in less than 4 months. In such situation, you are eligible to apply for your work permit extension, which is called bridging open work permit. Before you apply, you must need to know this. You are only eligible if you have already applied for a permanent residency under Express Entry or PNP nomination stream. Also, you must be a principal applicant in order to get extension under this work permit category. So you might have a question, what about my dependents? How they gonna get work permit extension? I will get that covered in few minutes. So hold on that. Another necessary condition is you must be living in Canada and that too out of Quebec province. Yes, Quebec residents do not have the bridging open work permit stream. Instead, they have to go through employer specific work permit extension program. And last but not the least, you must require acknowledgement letter from the IRCC. That letter you will get into your IRCC account while you submitted your PR application to IRCC. If you see that acknowledgement letter, the letter itself mentioned about your eligibility for the bridging open work permit, as you can see on the screen right now. So those who have applied under Express Entry stream, they only required acknowledgement letter from the IRCC as a proof of documentation. Instead, those who have applied under PNP stream, they required nomination letter alongside with the acknowledgement letter from the IRCC in order to get eligible for bridging open work permit extension. What's about dependent application? As I said before, only principal applicant can apply for a bridging open work permit application. Then you might be wondering, what's about my dependent application? How can I get extension for them? So here what you have to do. When you first try to apply for a bridging open work permit application, IRCC going to ask you some of the questions in order to define your category and eligibility. Some of the questions like, are you married or not? Will your dependent going to join you in Canada or not? Based on your answers, at the end of the process, IRCC will provide your document checklist for your application. On that page, if you see a 2 parts, then one is for you and another one will be for your dependent. As you can see right now on the screen, one document checklist is for myself and another one is for my spouse when I have applied for a bridging open work permit. Also, once you submitted your application to IRCC, it will generate 2 different applications with 2 different application number. Do not get confused over here. Even though you have applied for only 1 application for you and your dependent together, IRCC automatically generated 2 different applications for you and your dependents. Next is misconception about word implied status. I know many people having misconception about word implied status. Many people think that once they applied for a permanent residency application and they are waiting for the decision from the IRCC, and even though their work permits get expired, they do not have to do anything. They can work legally because they are on implied status, which is completely wrong. Implied status means you have already applied for a permanent residency under Express Entry or PNP stream. Also, you have applied for a bridging open work permit application, and now you are waiting for the decision of your work permit extension from the IRCC. During that time, you are eligible to work legally in Canada, which is called implied status. So my suggestion is, as soon as you are gets eligible for the bridging open work permit, do apply for it. Otherwise, you will ended up losing your job and status in Canada. Urgent work permit extension for emergency cases. This is quite complicated to explain, but I will try my best to make you understand. For the simplicity, I'm going to share my own experience. My work permit was about to expire in March 2020. So does my Canadian visa. Now, my employer wants me to travel overseas in month of April. In order to travel overseas and get back into the Canada in month of April, first I must have to extend my work visa. And in order to get a visa extension, first I have to get work permit extension. Here, urgent work permit extension terms comes into the picture. So let me tell you what I did. First, I applied online for bridging open work permit extension through IRCC. At that time, processing time was 90 days. Then next day, I called Client Support Center, CSC, and asked them to process my work permit extension on urgent basis and explain them my emergency business travel requirement. CSC asked me to provide a proof for my request through web form. So I requested my employer to provide me a letter which explained my business travel requirements, and he provided me the same. And the next thing, I raised a web form through my CIC account and attached the letter provided by my employer along with the letter of explanation as requested by CSC agent. One thing I forgot to mention, next day of submitting my application, I got biometric request from CIC. Usually, there is a 10 to 15 days of lead time in order to get a biometrics done into the Service Canada Center. I had submitted my biometrics within a 10 days. Once I submitted my biometrics, within a 2 days, I got approval for my work permit extension. Remember, original lead time was 90 days, but my application processed in less than 15 days. So yes, IRCC understand our emergencies and might process our application on urgent basis. Though only medical emergencies and business travel related emergencies considered as eligibility in order to get your work permit extension on urgent basis. So honestly, if you are in a such a situation, then it's not a bad idea to knock a door of IRCC with the hope they might listen. Bridging open work permit with flag pulling. In this scenario, if call center agent asks you or you are thinking to go on a Canadian border in order to get your work permit extension on immediate basis, please do not go stop. Flag pulling definitely works for the PR landing application or the work permit application, but it does not work for the bridging open work permit extension. If you go to border for your bridging work permit, then Canadian Border Service Agency will not accept your application. Remember, CBSA and IRCC are two different agencies. In order to get a bridging open work permit application, we have to deal with IRCC, not CBSA. Last but not the least, I heard many people having the difficulties to apply for a bridging open work permit application. They do not know from where to start. So if you want me to create a step-by-step process video on how to apply for a bridging open work permit, please let me know. I will do so. That's it. That's the wrap. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any question regarding the bridging open work permit application, you can ask me in a comment section. I will try my best to get back to you. If you find my content informative and helpful, please hit the like button below. That means a lot to me. For more video on Canadian immigration and lifestyle, please subscribe my channel. Until the next time, goodbye.